Welcome back. In the last video, I introduced you to global searches. In this video, I want to give you a few tips and tricks on using global searches. So let's take a look. All right, so we're here in our home dashboard, and let's go up to our global search. And again, we're going to, now this time, instead of just putting in a name, I'm going to specify a kind of a category or type of thing that I'm searching. So I'm going to put in, we had this employee Joe, right? So I'm going to put in employee, but I'm just going to shorten it and go EMP colon. It's important you put the colon in to specify this is the category and everything after the category is the actual thing that you're searching. So employee Joe. All right, good. So now notice the list that we had in the last video was a little longer because we also had a customer. But in this case, we're just getting employees that have Joe either in the name or in the record. So Connor Avery and Remy both have Joe in their email. So we get those and then we get Joel Metzger. But let's take a look at something other than just an employee. We can search a customer. Let's put Atlas. So good. CUS, we come up with any kind of customer, in this case with the name Atlas, of which we have a few. We can also search item. You can put IT colon. And let's just put in a number. So any item with 7 is appearing here. And this is including non-inventory items, services, inventory items. So we get those. We can do just about any type of record. We can do an opportunity. We can do a lead, LE. We can do a page, PA. And you don't have to get clever or remember kind of what are the shortcuts. It's always just the first few letters of that thing. And you can actually, like let's take sales order, for example. So SAL, I think it was 171. Yeah, so we get that sales order come up, but it doesn't have to be three letters necessarily. I could do SA171. Same thing comes up. I could write out sales fully and say 171. Sales comes up. So it doesn't really matter how much you write of it. Obviously, if you just write a C for customer, it's actually not gonna work because C could also be a contact, C-O-N. So you do need to put enough letters that it's really kind of narrowing it down to a certain category type. But as long as you put those letters down and you just know, okay, I'm looking for a lead. I can just put L-E or L-E-A colon. Okay, now what if you know generally what you're looking for, but maybe you don't know the exact spelling or you know kind of the concept, but there's elements that you're missing. You can actually type in, so let's put in Joe and then put in, we're gonna add the percent symbol. And that what that does, it's called a wildcard. And what it's doing is saying, okay, we're looking for Joe, but then after Joe, we can have any number of characters of any type that can be associated with that. So it could be Joe, in this case, like we have employee Joel. So that has an L and a bunch of other letters. The wildcard says that's totally fine. You could also put Joe, J-O, percentage symbol, wildcard, and it's going to pull up. In this case, all these things doesn't have a J-O-E. It's got J-O-A, Joaquin. It's got Johnson. We've got journal entry. Suddenly all these journal entries appear. So anything with that J-O and then after it. Now, here's a key thing. Obviously, this is specifying that the word has to start with J-O, at least one word, right? Joaquin starts with J-O and then can be anything after that. Let's take a look. If we add the wildcard to the beginning, it's very similar, but suddenly we clarify that it can come mid-word. So we have Vallejo and then J-O is at the end of that. So it's kind of anything comes before it and then J-O can also be included. So that's how you can use that. And you can put it in the middle. So let's do the wildcard and then J-O-U. So now journal entry. And also here, right, we have a J and then we have a U over here. And there's several characters in between the two. And the wildcard can basically accommodate for that. So that's basically how you would use that wildcard. Very helpful, again, if you're not sure about spellings or you know you want a sales order, but you're not totally sure about the number or you remember just one of the numbers, you can use that wildcard to get around it. Now, one additional thing, you can use the percentage wildcard. There's one additional thing you can do, which is adding an underscore. So let's do, first off, underscore L. So right now we get J-O, and the underscore is basically saying it can be anything but just one letter. It can't be a bunch of characters. It just has to be one thing in between. And in this case, it's represented by an E here. So the underscore, where that might be helpful is, for example, if we do, let's just go back, and if we do the percentage symbol there, we're gonna get these journal entries, all these journal entries, because we go J-O, a bunch of characters, and then an L. But we don't want a bunch of journal entries. We just know the guy's name was Joel, or maybe it was J-O-L-L. We don't totally know. So we put in the underscore, and it comes up with the exact name that we're looking for. So that's another useful kind of way to narrow down what you're looking for. And lastly, if you want an exact match, you don't want it to give you a bunch of suggestions, but you just know, I'm looking for this specific thing, and that's all that I want. So I'm looking for maybe sales orders by item. I don't want anything else, I just want that. So there's no alteration of that. It's exactly what you're looking for. You know, if it had sales order by item, it would not appear. It's just that exact search listing. So that's it on that. The last thing I'm gonna show you, just kind of a nifty trick. If let's say I've got my cursor down here, and let's say I want to now go into or access the global search bar. So what I can do is I can hold down Alt and then G, and notice my cursor hasn't moved, but suddenly I'm able to type things in the global search bar. So hitting Alt G gives us that ability to jump into the global search bar. And one additional thing, if I click down here and I go Shift Alt G, again, it looks the same, but now if I type into this global search bar, it's not gonna actually give me global search, it's only gonna give me the current page results. Remember, that's that bottom half that I showed you before. And it even shows you the trick over here, Alt-Shift-G is gonna give you that ability to pull up current page results. All right, that's it for tips and tricks on global searches. I'll see you in the next video.